What's going on, guys? It's CryptidTMG and I'm back with a brand new video. And finally, we're back Liga Racing. This is the AOR Assetto Corsa Competizione round one, season one of the GT3 Championship. And first round at Spa, and we've picked the Lamborghini Huracan GT3. Now, it's quite a difficult car to drive, not in the fact that it's sort of, you know, leery or anything, but it is quite twitchy, and you have to do quite a lot to the setup to get the car to work. And especially around Spa, it was a difficult track for this car. So we weren't expecting to sort of be battling for wins or anything like that. Unfortunately, we didn't actually manage to nail a good qualifying lap. We actually restarted the session. On the session before, I was about 8 tenths up on a 17.6, so that would have seen us into the 2 minutes 16s, which I would have been pretty happy with, but we didn't quite manage it on this lap. It was a lot more difficult, and the field is super stacked. You don't even understand how close the field is, and very difficult to sort of battle for wins in this league, man. Everyone is so quick, but guys in the Bentley for this race will definitely be the favourites. The Bentley does hold a significant speed advantage, especially in the race around this track, so going to be quite hard to compete with the Bentleys, but we're going to see what we can do. With overtaking and stuff, you have to be a little bit more wary, because little bits of damage do have quite a big effect in this game, so you're going to have to be quite patient and just try not to die at El Rouge. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. It's CryptidTMG. I'll see you in a bit. Peace.
And try and make sure I've got space ahead of me so I don't run into the back of anybody. You see how easy it is on the other side of the grid. You run into the back of someone. Someone's pulling over there. Oh, that's a free position. Well, you lost a couple positions. Literally can't see a damn thing. It's already kicking off. I think the second lap's going to be the dangerous one. Obviously with a Rouge. But there's literally nowhere to go at the moment. Trying to overtake cars, there's actually nowhere to go. Right, hold your breath, lads. I'm Nobody died? We're having to drive so slowly right now. Oh, someone's died. Yellow flags. Oh, a couple of people dead. And I think that's going to be our best way forward, lads. Just wait for the deaths. 2 minute 20s, wow. Such a scary corner. As if there's battling up ahead. We desperately need some of these guys to come off the track or something. Some of the corners actually impossible to see. Wow. That's almost spinning as well, Jesus. Mayhem. The other flag, someone's died at the top of El Rouge. Oh no, it's Prenta. They're dropping like flies, lads. desperately need to start passing some of these guys. Terrible run out of that corner.
Well done, mate. The fastest step so far.
I'm definitely playing it safe with El Rouge, having a lift before the corner, because it's just not worth the risk. Yellow flag's car on the wall. That car must have been a lap down. I think Exco is sort of holding the group up at the moment. And we need these guys to start fighting and try and take advantage of the fight. Oh, someone died again. It's a bad corner for us, lads. Oh my god. There goes our race. Our pace will definitely die now. Now let's see if we lose any straight line speed. Hopefully it's not too bad. A lot of understeer at the moment. Lots of understeer. Definitely seem to be struggling for straight line speed now, which is wonderful. And the front end is struggling to turn, so I might reduce the brake bias a bit. Oh, look at this. Look at my straight line. It's gone. Wonderful. Look at the amount of understeer I've got, it's crazy. Absolutely no straight line to defend move. Can't even do that flat anymore. Wow. Thank you. Look how much more speed you can carry through the corners. It's crazy. Honestly, got so much understeer right now. Barely even getting 19s. Wow. This goes lusty. Wow, the understeer is insane!
We're at the halfway mark, keep pushing.
So much quicker through that corner, it's crazy. Terrible turn one. Oh, there's nothing we can do about this one. And to make up any more positions, we're going to have to rely on people crashing. Because now we've got that damage, there's just nothing we can do. Such a struggle just to get the car to turn. Drive through for car 42. I'm pretty sure they're behind us anyway, so. I mean, in hindsight, it wasn't major contact or big contact, but it was enough to give me damage, man. And the moment you got any sort of damage on this game, you're so much slower. I mean, it's always annoying when you give someone room and they still hit you. That is always annoying. I wouldn't be surprised if Grand Fresh catches us as well. Well, now I understand it's crazy. Thank you. struggling at the moment, even with the brakes. You see Grand Fresh now gaining and gaining. This is the part of the track where I'm losing so much time. As the fuel load goes down, I'm able to take a little bit more risks. And the car definitely feels a lot lighter than it did at the start of the race. Uh-oh, that's gonna be a penalty. Definitely at this stage of the race should be in the mid to low 18, so I feel like I'm like a second down where I should be. Corner is so bad for understeer. I know it wasn't a big hit by Carsten, but geez, it's so costly, man. And I even think that's something that Kuno's need to actually sort out, because I don't believe a tap like that should cause you damage enough to slow you down significantly. But as soon as I got that tap, it's like I just lost all straight line, and now the car's just understeering for days.
Fastest lap.
Guys ahead might start battling soon. I did predict that a Bentley would win this race, to be fair. I'm not sure who's in first, but I'm pretty sure Jardia is destroying it. Oh, someone's died. It's two deaths. We're up to ninth. That is always the worry at the top of Radeon. Someone else has died. Is that casted in the wall? Oh, fantastic. I feel like that's a bit of karma right there. Man, I mean, that might sound salty, but come on, man. My pace has literally died since that contact. I have to be a little bit salty, lads. I tell you what, it's pretty tricky to race in a pack on this game. You really do have to brake a lot earlier. It's so easy to lock your brakes up and go into somebody. So easy to do that. I don't want to be too harsh on Obliteur or nothing, but I just feel like at that corner, shouldn't really be happening. We're going slow enough to be able to slow down in time, you know what I mean? Now, I'm pretty sure I left him space too, so... Now, he was probably just as frustrated as me, getting stuck behind probably some slower cars. But you gotta be patient, man. I mean, I see Blancpain cars rubbing shoulders all the time, man. I think they need to take their the damage down just a little. I don't believe it's that severe.